Did you do it for the look or other people you did it for yourself?
Myself. Like, I'm gonna be honest.
You had a lot of money. You always had a lot of money.
Since 2009. So let me tell you. I got cheated on a lot.
Really?
By a lot of like guys with better bodies.
Really?
Yeah. Just to be honest, I don't even care. You know what I mean?
Did that nigga say back?
You said what?
So if you were the chick, you obviously, nigga, your name is Bandman Kevo. You got the bag.
I got the bag. Whatever. It didn't make me feel bad. But
did them niggas that your shorty or whoever fucked, did they have the bag too?
No.
What? Oh, hell nah.
Yeah.
All right, man. So listen, as you can see, we reacting to DJ Academics and Bandman Kevo interview, bro. Basically breaking down or reacting to Bandman Kevo saying why he got his body done. Now, for me, I'm going to start off by saying, man, shout out to Bandman Kevo. I like dude. I respect dude. I like what he be doing with the money and all that. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's be honest, bro. It's not too many young black men out here that's focused on trying to get the youth into making money or investing or building businesses and stuff like that. So I rock with Bandman Kevo. I ain't gonna lie. I might be a little biased in this because I do rock with Kevo because of that, man. Because y'all know me. I'm on some trying to get rich shit. I'm still trying to touch my first M. So niggas like Kevo, you know what I'm saying? I look at certain shit that he do and I be like, let me figure out how that could, I could, you know what I'm saying? Just manipulate certain shit to where I could touch my M. You know what I'm saying? So I fuck with Kevo. I want to say that, you know what I'm saying, to start off, right? But I will say, bro, you just said you didn't get your body done for nobody else. You got it done for you. But then directly right behind that, you said you got your body done because you kept getting cheated on by dudes with better bodies. So that's not true. You didn't get your body done because you looked in the mirror and said, damn, I want to look better. You got your body done because you wanted to stop getting cheated on. You wanted to have that advantage. Like, you wanted to be the nigga with money and be the nigga with a nice body. Like, which is not, I mean, I wouldn't get my body done, me personally, just because I never had no real surgery. Thank God, I never had to have no surgery or get opened up or nothing like that. So I'm not personally about to put myself under the knife to look good. Like, I don't personally care about what people think that much. Like, at least not about my physical. Like, you call me broke, I'ma care. But you say I'm ugly or I got a pimple, I just popped a pimple, you could tell. I don't care. Like, shit like that, I don't care. Like, physical features, I really don't care because I never really, like, groom myself on who I am as a man of how I look. It's more like my principle, like how I live. You're not going to disrespect me. I smack the shit out you. You know what I mean? Those type of things. But let's get right back in, man.
This is so loyal.
I understand. I was just like, okay, cool. You know what I mean? Like, I'm like, I got the money. I'm rich. I got this. I got that. I don't give a fuck. Like, shit, it's your loss. But at the same time, I'm just looking at, like, we guys. So you're going to kind of look at a person like, damn, this person is really in shape. Especially if that person is like a weightlifter, like type of, like, okay, when you look at I don't know what type of women you like, but when we look at a woman we like, we usually like a nice set of titties and a nice ass, a flat stomach. We don't want nothing weird.
Yeah.
Women are the same way.
He right about that. Men, we do like our women a certain way. Like, if you could ideally make up your perfect woman, you're going to say she got to have nice titties. Whatever type of titties you like, you're going to say she got to have that. Whatever your preferences and waist to ass ratio, you're going to say she got to have that. So it's true, we do all have preferences. But my thing is, let's keep it 100, bro. When it come to men, I ain't going to lie, bro. If you doing your thing, bro, you got enough money to satisfy your lifestyle and you got enough swag and you just are confident in who you are, that's usually all it takes to get the woman you want. No cap. Am I wrong? Like, I know rich chicks probably have a certain standard that they want or whatever the case may be, but I don't think rich, like, Rick Ross is out here getting the bitches he want. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm telling you, bro, when you got money, I thought this shit didn't matter. All this, I'm fat, I'm sloppy. Like, nigga, it's a lot of fat niggas with money that's getting a lot of bitches. Let's keep it 100. Rod Wave is getting a lot of bitches, I'm sure. But let's keep going.
We got to be honest with ourselves.
A lot of times they don't vocalize it, though.
I don't know why, but they really... Have you ever been on a shade room?
Yeah.
And you'll see something and somebody showing in a box. Okay, let's...
These bitches be thirsty for safari, man.
That's a fact. When you're on shade room, my nigga, I even get... I even get mad at my own bitch when I go in the shade room and I go and I see my bitch like the photo of a nigga and his boxes and some shit. Like, bro, do you see how thirsty the bitches on the shade room be? Yo, you should see the comments under the shade room when it says buff nigga in shape and his boxes or something like advertising underwear and some shit. The bitches in the comments, oh my God, oh, oh, oh. They be going crazy. I ain't gonna lie, they do be lusty. And like I said, I don't be seeing my bitch in the comments because if I see you in them comments, it'd be a problem. But I do be seeing her in the likes. And I be like, yo, hey, damn, relax. Like, cousin, they got some muscles and wearing some briefs. Like, you liking the, get out of here. Like, don't disrespect me. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, I know what he mean though. It's true. Like, you know what I'm saying? The chicks do be lusty a lot when they see a nigga, a muscular nigga. Like on the shade room, when the shade room post a nigga like that, you know, go look at the comments, bro. Y'all know
the fuck
NLE Chopper.
Yeah,
remember when this viral picture came out and all these thirsty ass girls was under there?
I was reading the comments. What's up with these hoes?
Okay, now they just posted some guy in a kitchen, like a chef, on the shade room or something, and they were like, "Oh yeah, it's giving." Girls are cap, bro.
It's giving. Oh my God, it's giving. Look at that. Like that. These bitches kill me, bro. These bitches kill me, my nigga. Like, bro, you got a nigga at home. What if your nigga saw you in them comments talking about it's giving? Bitch, shut up. Do you got a BBL? Are you snatched like a motherfucker? Do you weigh 115? Is your waist like this? No, you're not perfect. So don't be on the shade room doing that, bitch. No. Because then when I go, comment. So stop. The fuck?
And those are the same ones that will mess with that guy with $0 just for that.
That's where I disagree. That's where I disagree, my brother. You was talking real shit. But here's where I disagree. You got money, these bitches is going. More than, like 70% of women. Obviously, there's still that 30% that we all trying to grab. We all want a wife. The 30% that's not going to just move off of money. The 30% that don't just move off money. Like, oh, a nigga got money, she's cheating on you for him. She'll leave you for him because he got more money. Even though you ambitious and you grinding and you know what I'm saying? You got the same potential to get that kind of money. But because a nigga already got it, it's like, man, fuck what I'm doing over here. I leave and just, you know what I mean? We all trying to get that 30% of women who actually got some loyalty to them. The ones that actually like, they like a nigga because they like a nigga. They like a nigga because of what? They see the nigga not only because the money that he's spending. You know what I mean? So, I'm going to tell you this. That's cat. Bro, a nigga could be buff as shit, nigga. And a nigga could be, all right, this nigga right here, buff as fuck. No money. This nigga right here, fat, but got money. Guess what? This nigga right here is getting more bitches. At least in the real world. Like, now, if we just in the neighborhood, in the hood, in the projects, yeah, I ain't going to lie. A lot of homeless, dirty, dusty niggas get the most pussy. Bro, I was a dusty, dirty nigga getting a lot of pussy in the jacks. Not gonna lie to you, bro. Patterson Projects, born and raised, nigga. Not a lot of money, but fucking a lot of bitches. Yes, no cap. I'm telling you, my nigga. So I disagree, bro. I disagree. But at this age where we grown, my nigga, grown bitches is not just fucking a nigga. Like, they might let them fuck, but they're not about to leave they nigga or cheat on they nigga who really bringing in paper for some broke nigga. I doubt it. She just gotta be a dummy if she do that. Like, bitch, you fucking up the plan. You fucking up the package.
Let me ask you something. I watch porn. Girls watch porn, correct?
Yeah.
It's 90% of guys that look like what on porn?
I would imagine they look to something.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, nice bodies, right?
Yeah.
I'm not looking at the niggas. When I watch porn, keep it 100. I'm not really paying much attention to the niggas. But I guess I get what he means. Like... They usually brolic or whatever, like, they usually, like, in shape niggas. But the bitches in porn is usually that, too. Unless you watch some BBW porn, you know what I'm saying? Which I fuck with it, because sometimes I want to see a big bitch get clapped. You know what I'm saying? I want to see a big bitch get thrown. Yes.
Okay, so they watching a lot of this, so that's what, and when they playing with themselves with their little rolls or their little dildos, that's what they want, bro. We just sometimes just got...
Bro, the problem with Kev right now, I fuck with you, Kev, but your problem is, bro, you care too much about what bitches care about. And as a nigga, bro, especially a nigga like you, bro, you got millions, you sitting on millions, my nigga, you got a following, you famous out here, you caring too much about what bitches think, nigga. Bitches gonna fuck with you because you confident in you. No funny shit, my nigga. I bet you could have fucked the same bitches you fucking right now if you didn't get surgery. Because when you came, when you started getting in shape and working out and all that shit, nigga, you was on your shit. You was looking like something. You know what I'm saying? You look like a solid, how niggas come home with the jail body and shit. You was looking like, you know what I'm saying? You was in shape and shit. I don't think you had, I'm not mad at you getting the surgery because I don't care. To me, what one man do with his body, other niggas shouldn't be judging. You know what I'm saying? So I'm never going to judge him going to get his body done. If anything, if I am judging anything, it's the mind frame behind getting the body done. But really what I'm doing is just breaking down why he think what he think. But I, me personally, I just don't care what nobody think enough. Like, I don't care what bitches think enough. I don't care what niggas think enough. Because at the end of the day, who's for me is for me. And who I'm going to fuck regardless. Like, why am I worried about the knots, the people who don't fuck with me? I'm worried about the people who fuck with me. You know what I'm saying? But I get it. Everybody not the same. Like, some people care more about what other people think than others. And I can respect that. You know what I mean? Especially when you famous and you know what I mean? You trying to fuck a certain type of bitches. You trying to fuck the same bitches Drake fucked. You know what I mean? And Drake might have got his body done. I don't know.
Honest with ourselves. But a lot of people, the world is so dishonest, bro, that they'll be like, oh, well, you know, no. But then when she do cheat, like a girl, let me tell you about my life, bro. I've been with girls that act like money didn't mean shit to them. Oh, money don't mean nothing. You got.
They all act like that shit. They all act like money don't mean nothing when they know you got money. But I tell you, to us regular niggas who not rich, no, bitches let it be known that money means something. But when you rich, when you a rich nigga, the bitches don't want to come around you acting like money means something because they don't want you to feel like they only around you for the money. You know what I'm saying? It's like a psychology method. You know what I'm saying? But when you not rich, bitches all the time let you know like, yeah, I wish I could be going to Paris. I wish I could be doing this. I want to be doing this. I want to be driving a Bentley. I want to be doing that. Bitches, to regular niggas, we know money means something. There's no money don't mean nothing to regular niggas because we hear that shit all the time. Bitches gonna always tell you what they want to be doing. Like, you know what I'm saying? The trips they want to go. A bitch gonna always tell you about the shit that they want to do that money is involved in that right now, currently, nigga, you're not able to do. Like, that's just females. They do that. But that's regular niggas, though. Rich niggas, they don't want to say that to the rich niggas. They just want the rich niggas to provide. Or they gonna just make them, you know what I'm saying? You know how that, you get what I'm trying to say if you get what I'm trying to say.
With a nigga with a better body than you or a nigga with more money than you.
It's just that simple.
That simple.
When did you first find out that a girl cheated on you? I think that's a depth.
Bro, I'm high as fuck. What is this I'm smoking on? I'm smoking on some good runts right now, bro. Shout out to my weed man. Shout out to my son, Walt. Had to say that, bro, because I'm smacked. Let's keep going, though.
An experience for a guy.
I started young. You know, my mom kicked me out when I was 15.
All right, hold on. So I'm going to advance it to when you had something.
Because, you're right. Okay.
A lot of guys, and for anybody watching, it's like, you're going to go through life, but once you feel like you've made it to a certain extent, you almost feel like, not to use my infamous line at this point, nigga, you the prize. A chick cheating on you, like, what the fuck is she doing? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So when that happened to you, like, how did you even find out or even realize, like, what the fuck? Nigga, you Kevo at this point, like, bitch, I mean, cheating on Kevo, like she finessed herself.
Yeah, so it was crazy, bro. I ain't even gonna lie to you. Like I was doing a lot, you know, for a person, and, you know, I bought him a car, and I found out, you know, because I had a tracker in my car.
If I buy you a car, you cheat on me, I'm taking the car back. Fuck out of here. I don't give a fuck. If I buy you a car, bitch, a car, like, a nice car, like, that I had to pay off, that I, like, spent thousands of dollars on, and you cheat on me, the car's coming back.
You know what I mean?
It's coming back home to daddy.
Just in case, because it's Chicago, it could come up stolen.
Oh, really? You put a track on.
But I bought it for her, but it's my car. You get it?
Yeah.
So, I'm like, why the fuck is my car
put a track on the car.
At a studio movie grill. Movie theater. You know what I'm saying? I'm working. I'm out here getting money. You know what I'm saying? So, me and I tell my homies, man, come to my crib ASAP. I hop in my BMW.
You think it's stolen?
Yeah. I'm like, what's going on? But then I don't think it's stolen. I'm calling Shorty. She ain't picking up. I'm like, it's at a studio movie grill where I always take her to. So, we 4D. We ran in the car. We on our way out there. It's like a 30-minute drive from Chicago type shit. I see my car. And I see my car on. I see my car on.
Starting to move again?
Oh, she couldn't be getting dug out.
Parked. Oh.
If the car on, she couldn't be getting dug out, right? Because I know when I pipe bitches, I turn the car off. Just in case I don't want the police to walk up, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I turn the car off. Right? I turn the car off when y'all piping a bitch out, right? I turn the car off. I'm waiting. For one, I don't know how long I'm gonna be piping this bitch out for. It's gonna be a quickie because we in the car, but it might be more longer than 10 minutes. That's a lot of gas to be burning. But then again, if it's cold outside, I need to keep it comfortable. But then again, we're gonna fog it up and I turn the car off.
It's like a replay. Like, I see my car on, I pull up behind my car. Now, it's on means somebody in the car.
Yeah, of course.
The girl is in the car.
Yeah.
Okay. My BMW, 10 and 1 of those black 24-inch Ford Giattos, blocking the car. Is, you know, it's...
Quick flex. Can I get a little rich flex for me? 21. Can you do something for me? That was a rich flex. Except, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Ford Giattos on it. Blacked out. You know what I mean? He got to say all the extras. Got to add the details.
This round is blocking. So... I got my pipe with me, my home. We like four deep in the gun. In the car.
What do you think is going on at this point?
Bro, I don't know what the hell going on. I'm kind of scared because, you know, I got it's tent windows type shit. I'm like, so I'm steady calling. Ain't nobody picking up still.
But the car on.
Yes. So I tell my homie, hey, bro, get out the car and walk around, you know, the front of the window. My homie say, man, your girl and this dude in the car in the car like this.
Nah.
But they dumb.
Not trying to hide. Not doing a. Hope they don't see us. Not trying to hide, bro. Not trying to hide.
Just forgot to turn off the car. Get it? It's almost like they think they hit in the car. That's not on, but we see that the
stupid
lights on.
Dumbass motherfucker.
Gee, I was so fucked up.
Bro, any of y'all ever caught your bitch cheating on you, man? Like, directly caught your bitch cheating on you? I'm going to say this. I never directly caught a bitch cheating on me, but I have thought I was getting cheated on before. And then one time, I got fooled. Like, the shorty had the same name as another girl. So I thought they was talking about my girl when they said this girl was doing this, X and this, but it wasn't my girl. I looked stupid trying to bring that shit to her. Like, you was doing this, you was doing that. She's like, bro, that's not me. That's a whole nother. And I'm like, oh, shit, I'm wrong. My bad. You're just popping. But let's keep going.
Right? So I was just like, damn, this crazy. Like, I didn't even know what to do, really. Like, I'm like, okay, I got this. We got guns, this and that. There's a dude in my car.
Nigga, put the gun away.
I said, you know what?
Put the gun away. He ain't kidnapped the bitch. He just fucked her. Put the guns away. Put the guns away, nigga. Ain't no need for the guns today. He just fucked your bitch and sent her on her way. Like, yo, it be like that, though. Real shit. Like, my nigga, everybody has been a victim. Just like we out here fucking bitches and sending them home. Nigga, somebody's doing that shit to the next bitch. Now, that's the thing. You got to know who you with. That's why you got to know your girl. Don't cuff no bitch who you think going to be out here fucking around on you. Like, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, man, that's the interview, man. Bandman, Kevo, DJ Academics. I think that's the end.
I got out the car.
Yeah, man. That's the end of the shit, man. You know what I mean? The lesson from this is, I guess, sometimes, bro, bitches just be cheating. Like, but I ain't gonna lie. If she cheated on a rich nigga with a broke nigga, that was just weird. That was weird. That's different. Unusual. But shout out to my son, DJ Academic. Shout out to Bandman Kevo, man. Like I said, I fuck with both of them niggas, both of them boys, man. I'm off this nasty. I see y'all in the next one. Jimmy Gang, like, comment, subscribe. Get engaged, man.